Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah, yes, Pawan.
Okay, good.
Yes.
Good evening, Will. Yeah.
Hey.
Fine. So let's start today about WebDriver, Selenium WebDriver concept. So we have completed that. So that is more than enough for learning Selenium. Meanwhile, while you are practicing, if you have any questions, you can also ask me. So now today's we'll comment on driver concept. So today's agenda is let us see the basic overview or introduction of the Selenium driver, and also some of the main board API, and how we need to use it and how to download and install and everything. And then we will see how creating the driver basic out.
Question, yes. Pawan. Are you going to cover the Selenium ID or no?
Yes. Yes.
Okay.
Okay. So ID is required locating elements actually. Basically, wherever it is required, I'll introduce ID. But that is not a separate kind of session. So wherever it is required, I'll introduce ID. Okay. Okay, so this is the agenda concept. So WebDriver API and how to download and Eclipse, configure with Eclipse, and then we will see how to create a basic WebDriver scripts. Okay, so in the beginning class, the introduction class, I told some of the points about the Selenium, right? Selenium has certain components. Do you remember what are the components of Selenium?
The what?
What are the Selenium components? So component. In class, we have discussed some of the points.
Yeah, IDE, the web driver, the remote, the RC.
And then remote control, then remote grid control.
TestNG.
TestNG is not part of component actually. TestNG is a Java technology. We can use that for organizing our test cases and testing and so on. A TestNG is not part of a Selenium component. It's not a Selenium suite actually. Okay. So these are all are related to the Java technologies.
Okay.
Incorporating them for the best automation script. Okay, so IDE, WebDriver, remote control, and grid. These are the only components we have. So IDE is, again, it is integrated develop environment. It is for Firefox plugin. This is for just a small plugin we can install with the Firefox and use it for just to record playback and tool. Very basic test cases we can automate, very, very basic. So complex kind of logical things and we cannot validations, we cannot perform by using IDE, so that it is not much become popular actually. Okay, so based on that limitation, other components are came into the picture. So when I go to the WebDriver, before WebDriver, there was another component called RC is become popular before WebDriver. Okay, so RC is also having some limitations because this is very complex kind of installation, and also this is very slower because client to our script should talk to the RC and RC should talk to the application. These are indirect process communication. So because of that reason, it becomes very slow. So later point of time, what the people think is whatever the new features are implemented, they make it as another component called WebDriver. This is a lot of architectural changes between RC and WebDriver. So WebDriver, if I write some script, it will directly, it will communicate with the server. So when I see this one, okay, this is the way. So suppose if you see the RC, you means here this is a script, this is a browser. So this is indirect process. RC server sit between script and browser, it will talk to them. But if you come to the web driver, you directly talk to the browser. So in this way, your communication will become more faster. Okay, so web driver. So
question.
RC is become, yes.
So if WebDriver is better,
yes,
is it worth the time to learn about RC? Well,
RC,
one is requesting RC?
Okay. Okay, so let me clarify this one actually. So when Selenium is started, people were started using RC, remote control, at the beginning days. For 1 or 2 years, it was become very much popular. Later point of time, what Selenium group is think about, like new features, whatever new features they have, they did some architectural changes in RC. Okay. So because of that architectural changes, they observed two things. Because one is thing like web installation is very easy, configuration is very easy, and other thing is it's very faster than RC. So after changing the small architectural changes, they make as a web driver. This is a different component. And after that, web driver became very much popular. Okay. So then Selenium people group stopped implementing the new features on top of RC, and they can migrated everything whichever is there in RC to web driver. Okay.
Right.
So from web driver 2 onwards, RC is rolled back again. So RC is not there in the market now. So RC is there in the older version, but nowadays 99% of the companies not using RC, because Selenium is not at all implementing the new features on RC. Okay, they are newly implementing everything on WebDriver. And after WebDriver 2, there is another version came, WebDriver 3. This is current version of WebDriver. Current version. And not only 3, we have a 3 dot something called 1 and 3 dot 2, and also we have some 3 dot X, 3 or 4 something going on. So this is the current version of the WebDriver. So WebDriver 1 is also called as RC actually. So WebDriver 1. See, RC is itself called as a WebDriver 1 actually. Okay. RC is called as a WebDriver 1. WebDriver 1. Okay. So then from WebDriver 2 onwards, they have started implementing the new features so that in the market it becomes very much popular because of very less complex. And also, so RC, whatever features RC contains, everything WebDriver also have. So RC support multiple languages, the same number of languages WebDriver also will support. But only the difference is in architectural changes. RC works as a server between the client and the browser. But in WebDriver, there is no server between the client and browser. There will be direct interaction. Because of that reason, the execution will become very much faster. Okay. So nowadays people are using WebDriver, and in future also there are many versions will come on top of WebDriver, not on RC. This is already rolled back around 3 years back. Okay, nowadays this is not preferring at all. So we are going to learn purely on WebDriver, not on RC part. Okay, and then grid component. Even if you use RC, nowadays new kind of browsers and setups will not support RC. Okay, so Internet Explorer, Firefox or Chrome, latest kind of browsers will not support RC. Okay, so last two component is a grid component. So grid is basically used for interacting, executing your automation test scripts on remote machines. Suppose if you have Unix machine, or one more is Linux machine or Windows machine. So if you want to execute your automated script on remote machines, so that case grid will be very much useful. So these are basically Selenium components: IDE, RC, WebDriver and grid. Okay, so one more important point is here, Selenium is not a automation tool. Tool is nothing but a single component. You can download and we can install and start using it. But Selenium is not like that. So Selenium is a multiple components, collection of multiple components. And component is nothing but these are all comes under the APIs. IDE is an application, just a plugin we can install Firefox. But WebDriver is not like that. WebDriver is an API. So what is API? First, let us understand this one. Application. Programming interface, application programming interface. This is basically an API. Okay, so what is API? How it will work? Suppose, for example, you have one task. For example, if you want to perform some task. Okay, so you are busy with some other work. So what you have done is you have assigned this task to some person A, some X person. Okay, so what this X person will do is he will perform this task and provide to you the output. So whatever task you are going to do, you are busy with something else. So you have assigned the same task to X. So what X will do is X will perform the same task and provide to the output. So what is the role of X here? So it is assisting you for performing a task or completing the task, right? So X knows how to perform the task, how to complete the task. So just you have assigned the task to the X. He is a person, he will do the, he will perform everything and he will provide the output to you. Okay, the same thing application programming interface also will do. So application programming interface, API, is a mediator. So it will assist us to perform certain tasks. Okay, suppose WebDriver is also an API, Grid is also an API. Okay, so as I said, WebDriver is API. What it will do? It will do browser automation. So if I provide some instruction to the WebDriver, it will automatically execute those instructions against that application and it will perform certain task. So for question. Example, yes.
Question. On yes. Eclipse, does Selenium or the WebDriver API, yes. does it show up with the IntelliJ Sense?
Yes, yes. Yes, you can use everything Eclipse and IntelliJ also.
Okay. Good, good.
Right. So now, application programming interface. This is a basic concept of API. So WebDriver is a API, we can say, and also WebDriver is an interface. So how it implemented? See now, in Java, if you come back to the Java, if you want to use certain methods, we need to import appropriate packages, right? So if you want to use some methods, we need to import appropriate packages. Actually, where those packages are available or where the packages are present in Java API. In default Java API, whenever you install your Java, so by default you will get those APIs. So once you import that particular package, you are using the method. So first important thing is Java API. So I'm not talking about the WebDriver and anything, just I'm talking about the normal API, Java API. So how we will get this Java API? Once you have installed Java, you will get all your Java APIs. So what these APIs contains? These APIs contains the packages. Multiple packages. There are a lot many packages it contains. And again, what these packages contains? These packages contains different classes. And what is class contains? Classes contains different methods, right? So this is a hierarchy. So if you want to use particular method, what we need to do, we need to import a class. If you want to import the class, we need to specify the package. You need to import package with class. And if you want to import that package, this package should be present under API. So by default, if I install Java, I'll get default packages, default Java packages or default Java APIs, which contains multiple packages and it contains again classes and the methods. In similar way, if you import, if you install WebDriver API, observe this one, okay? WebDriver API, for example. It is also contains certain packages and also it contains certain classes and it contains methods. Okay, so now what are all different packages, classes, methods or contains in WebDriver API? So basically when WebDriver API started, they have concentrating on Firefox browser because they had taken as a Firefox as a default browser for Selenium. Okay, later point of time they have implemented the same thing for Internet Explorer, Chrome and other browsers. So WebDriver API basically initial level it focuses on Firefox browser. Okay, so they have implemented WebDriver API. So what is API again? It contains packages, it contains classes and methods. Similar way, WebDriver API is also user defined API. Some group of people, they have implemented this API. It contains many packages and it contains different classes and methods. Who has implemented this? It's a group of people, Selenium people, they have implemented everything and make it as jar files. They packaged it in jar files. Packaged them in jar files. Okay. So the jar files are available online. So if you download the jar files, and if you attach those jar files in your project, in Eclipse project or Java project, and then we will get everything, all the packages, classes and methods from WebDriver API. And then we can start using them. Okay, so if you install normal Java, you will get only default packages, classes and methods, but they are not useful for automation, browser automation. But if you want to do browser automation, you need to download WebDriver API, and it contains certain packages, classes and methods, but they don't provide directly packages, classes and methods. We cannot see these packages, classes and methods implementations, but we can still use them. Even though if you don't see the implementation, how they have written the code inside, but still we can use those packages, classes and methods. And they have packaged everything into jar files. Okay, they have packaged everything into jar files. So these jar files are available online. Okay, now we understand what is API, what is Java API and what is WebDriver API. So what is WebDriver API? It contains a multiple packages, classes and their methods, and everything they are packaged to jar files. Now we understand what are all the classes mainly available on WebDriver API. So before implementing the WebDriver API, the people concentrated on only one browser, that is Firefox browser.
Question.
Yes.
So can the WebDriver API be considered as a framework?
Yes.
Okay.
We can also define in many ways actually. WebDriver as an interface, or WebDriver is an API, or a WebDriver is a framework. Okay. So we can define many ways. See, right. when WebDriver came into the picture, so initially WebDriver concentrated on only one browser, that is Firefox browser. So because after that they have seen Chrome, Firefox and Internet Explorer and Mozilla, so Opera, so many browsers are available. So we don't know exactly how many browsers will come in future. So what they have done is, we don't know exact requirement, right? In future, how many browsers will come into the picture, we don't know. How many browsers we are going to support, that also we don't know initial days. So what they did is they have implemented one interface. So what is interface? In Java we learn about interfaces, right? What is interface? Interface is nothing but contains the
abstract
methods. So only methods are defined, definition is there, but there is no body at all. The body can be implemented by using multiple classes, right? So similar kind of concept they have used here. So they have created WebDriver interface. Observe this. So at the initial level, so this is how WebDriver started actually. So they have implemented WebDriver interface. So WebDriver, I'm saying interface. What is interface now? WebDriver interface means it contains methods, but they don't have any body. Okay, they don't have any body. It contains certain methods. So here WebDriver is an interface. Observe, interface, WebDriver, they have created like this WebDriver. In this there are many methods that are available. Suppose m1, m2, m3, there are n number of methods, only definition part, not a body part.
Question.
And these methods, yes.
I want to ask now, just in case you come across it, I was interviewing for Selenium. Okay. And they asked me, have you worked with any singletons?
And
singleton? Singleton. Or is Selenium a singleton? So if you can think of that question and answer the question, I don't know.
Singleton is really singleton is basically a class actually. I'll talk about this sometime.
Okay, sure.
Okay, so interface started like this. So WebDriver started like this. They make WebDriver is an interface. Why? Because in future we don't know how many methods are required and how many classes are required, because how many browsers will come into the picture we don't know in future. So initially they have started WebDriver as an interface. I have created WebDriver as an interface. In WebDriver, they have created many kinds of methods. These methods interact with the browser actually. Okay, they have created the code. So they haven't implemented any code in the interface. They have implemented the classes. So they have implemented class for Firefox. okay, Firefox driver. This is the one class they have implemented. And also they have every browser, they have implemented one new class. Suppose Internet Explorer class or Internet Explorer driver. This is one class they have implemented. And same class Chrome. So this is a class, another class. For every browser, they have implemented the class. And here, implemented web driver. This is how we need to do, right? Yes, yes, I will say.
Pavan, I would like to explain this interface web driver one more time because I'm getting confused.
Okay, so the driver initial days, the web driver is created as an interface. So just I'm explaining how web driver came into the market, how people thinking about the web driver. Okay, so if you want to understand the web driver, first you need to understand API. So normal in Java programs, if I want to use certain methods, I have imported some packages, right? Did you observe this one?
Yes. Up to WebDriver API, I understand what you explained. Okay. Afterwards, you started the interface WebDriver and Bill asked some question and I got confused.
Okay. Right. So WebDriver basically support multiple browsers, right? So WebDriver should support multiple browsers. If you want to automate, you can use multiple browsers. Some people will use Internet Explorer, some people will use Chrome, or some people will use Firefox. Many browsers are available.
Yeah.
That is one. Other thing is, if you want to interact with the browser, we should require many more methods. So every method is responsible for doing certain tasks. So to keep in mind these things, Selenium group of people, what they have think is, we don't know exactly what is implementation future, but we know the definition part. We know what are all methods should be there, right? So because of that reason, they make WebDriver as an interface. They have created WebDriver as an interface. So what is interface? When we have to define interface, if you know the body or if you know the definition, if you don't know the body or we don't know the implementation, in such cases we will define the interface. Okay,
interface.
So initial days they make it WebDriver as an interface. So as soon as I say interface, it should contain only abstract methods. So this, they have just defined the methods, but they haven't implemented anything. Okay, this is a just WebDriver interface came into the picture.
Okay.
Now, later point of time, for every browser, they have created one class. Okay, and that class is implemented these WebDriver methods. Suppose Firefox driver is a class. So when I say Firefox driver implemented WebDriver, what should happen now? These methods should be implemented here. Okay, now body should be present here. Right? So similar case. Yes. Will, do you have any question?
No, I was answering your question.
Yes, right. So now similar way for Internet Explorer also, they have implemented same methods, but a different body. And for Chrome also, they have implemented the methods for different body. So why they have created these many classes? Because each and every browser is independent. So each and every browser is independent. In architectural level changes will be there, and some methods also different from one browser to another browser. So the same interface is implemented in Firefox driver, Internet Explorer, and also here also we have to implement the web driver. Here also implemented the web driver. And these are the different classes, Firefox driver, Internet Explorer driver, Chrome driver. So these are all the different classes actually. So these classes implemented the methods which are defined in the web driver. So this way we have many number of classes, and these classes are present in again different packages. And these web driver interface and classes and their methods, everything is packaged in jar files. Now these jar files are available online. Now if I download these jar files and configure them in your Java project, in your Eclipse, then we can directly use everything. So this is how WebDriver should be used. So Selenium WebDriver is not a tool. It is basically an API. It is a collection of some jar files. These jar files contain certain packages, classes and methods. Okay. Now this is how we need to do. This is the basic introduction about the Java WebDriver API is designed. So WebDriver API is a interface. WebDriver basically is interface implemented with multiple classes. Every class contains as a browser. Okay, suppose if you are going to use Firefox browser for automation, so which class you need to use? Firefox driver class. And if you want to use Internet Explorer class, Internet Explorer browser, though, you need to use Internet Explorer driver class. And if you want to use Chrome browser, then you need to use class Chrome driver class. So depending on the browser, you need to use appropriate class. So all the classes are implemented by using WebDriver interface only. Okay, so this is the initial stuff they have started. So this is a basic concept of WebDriver. Now let us see another concept. We have just discussed about the WebDriver introduction and API. Now we'll see how to download and configure that into our Eclipse. Okay, now let us come back. So if you want to configure this WebDriver, this is not much complex thing, very easy. So anyway, we have created a Java project. So first thing is we need to create a Java project as usual. On top of Java project, we will import the WebDriver jar files. Now, if you observe this one, this is my project I have created and we have done all the programs, right? These are all the different packages. These are the different user different packages and Java programs I have created, right? So now what I want to do here is same project again. Now what I want to do here is I want to configure this same project with a WebDriver project. So if you want to make this project as a WebDriver project, what are the steps should be followed? Now let me write creating WebDriver project in Eclipse. So very simple. So the first thing you need to create Java project, normal Java project. Without Java project, you cannot. So on top of Java project, what you need to do is second thing is you need to download WebDriver jar file. So from where we need to download this. So anyway, we have created a Java project, right? So on this Java project, I can make this as a WebDriver project, or else if you want to create a new project, you can also create a new project. Okay, so now let me create this as a Java project. Let me make this as a WebDriver project. How we can make this a WebDriver project? So before that, let me show you how to download. Okay, how to download Java files. So let me introduce you a Selenium website. When I type Selenium in WebDriver, in Google, the first site it will show is seleniumhq.org. So this is the official site of Selenium. So in future, if you want to download something or if you want to refer the documentation, examples, everything can be done on the particular site. So this is the basic Selenium official site. Okay, seleniumhq.org. So if you want to download something, so here there is a download section. So here, from here, there are so many downloads are available, browsers and drivers and there. So wherever, whichever is required, we need to download the particular part. Now here, the second step is we have created Java project. Then we need to download WebDriver jar files because I want to make this Java project as WebDriver project. So I need to download WebDriver jar files. I just said, what is jar file? So jar file contains all the packages, classes and methods which are implemented for WebDriver. Okay, now go to the here, and if you observe this particular site, if you come down, Selenium client and WebDriver language bindings, you need to come to this particular session. So in this particular session, so this is a current version of these are as I said, WebDriver support multiple languages: Java, C Sharp, Ruby, Python and JavaScript. So these are the multiple languages supported by WebDriver. So this is the current version. 3.4.0 is the latest version of the Java. So now 3.3 and 3.4 is the current version of WebDriver. 3.4 is the current version of WebDriver. So which one we need to download here? So we are going to use WebDriver with Java. So we need to download this part. Okay, so this is a URL. This is a URL. So under this, we need to download this particular session. Okay, so if I click on this download, it will download the jar file. So when I click on the download here, so it will directly download Selenium iPhone Java iPhone 3.4.0.zip. It will provide us a zip file. Okay, now download is completed. When you download this file, you will get as a zip file. Okay, so if you unzip that particular file, you will see a lot of files, a lot of jar files basically. So let me open this. Okay, now we've done. Now go and show folder. It is a zip file basically. So this is my zip file. Now let me copy that for you. Okay, this is the zip file, I got it. Okay, now if you extract this particular zip, extract all. Is extracting.
Does it matter where you put it?
Can you come again, Avil?
Does it matter where you
can extract anywhere? Just I wanted to show you what are all files you will get from the zip file. Okay. So you can extract anywhere. This is preferable way is just put everything in one folder. For C drive, because in going further, we are also download. We are going to download lot many stuff, lot many things. Okay, so if you keep everything in one place, it is very easy to refer. Okay, so now I have extracted this file. If I open this, it contains some jar file here. This is one jar, and if you go to the leaf folder, you will see lot many jar files. Okay, these are all the jar file. It contains many number of packages, classes and methods and everything. So now if you import or if you use, if you attach or if you configure these all jar files in your Java project, then your Java project will become WebDriver project. So we can use all the classes, methods which are coming from these particular jar files. Okay, so the best way is just I have shown you how to download the zip file and how to extract. So always prefer to keep this folder in your Eclipse folder itself. So in C drive, I have a program files under Eclipse. You always put everything under Eclipse. So in going further, we will download so many drivers, jar files, and so much stuff. So better to think in your drive itself. Okay, so in the Eclipse folder itself, or else if you want to make another folder other than Eclipse, you can also make another new folder and keep everything there. Because you no need to confuse in future. So now I have a 3.0.0.0. This is a little older version, and after that 3.4.0. So these are the jar files contents, right? Now what I need to do is, so I have downloaded my jar files and also my Java project is ready, or else I can create a new project. Okay, just let me show you. So let me create a new Java project. Okay, so let me create.
Is it like better to create a new project good or like use the old one? Is which one is more preferably?
Always, in real time you always create a new project, right? So this is just a practice purpose. Okay. Create the same project again. And if you want to create, if you want to make this as WebDriver, you can do it, or else I'll create a new project for WebDriver. That's better. Okay. Because all WebDriver scripts and programs I'll write in one project. Okay, so now let me create Java batch to WebDriver. Okay, this is my new project. So now click on the finish. Okay, so now it is a fresh project. This is purely Java project. So if we expand this, I can create only Java programs in this particular project. Now I want to associate WebDriver jar files to this particular project. Now what you need to do is right click on this project, and go to the properties. Go to the properties. Here Java build path. So here source, projects, libraries there, right? So go to the library section. So currently the project is pointing to only Java. It contains only Java. Now we need to add all our jar files. So here go to add external jars.
Okay.
And then select whatever jar files you have downloaded. This is a new version, right? So select this one and add all the jar files. So first add this one. One jar is added. And go add external jars. Go to the lib folder. Select all the jar files. Open. Now we have added all the jar files in our project. Then click on OK. Now what happens? This project becomes, if I see here, reference library section is created, newly created. Under this, you will see all the jar files. Okay.
Okay.
Now this project is become WebDriver project. So now onwards, I can create all my WebDriver programs. Also Java programs also you can create, not a problem. Okay. In addition, you'll get the features of WebDriver.
Okay.
Now I have created a WebDriver project. I have created WebDriver project. So how to associate? Third step. Created Java project and download a WebDriver jar files. And third is, so associate jar files to project. Java project. Okay, so how to right click on project. Properties. A library section, add external jars. Okay, this is the flow. So once again, I will show you. Right click on the project, properties, Java build path. So here, Java build path, and this library session, and then add external jar files. Okay, you need to add all your jar files. So this is how we need to create WebDriver projects and also associate a jar files to your Java project. Now your WebDriver project is ready. Then we can start our writing WebDriver programs. Okay. Now.
Yeah.
So is it clear so far?
Yes.
This is very simple configuration. Okay.
Yep.
Now we have seen how to download WebDriver jar files and how to associate with your Eclipse project.
Question.
Now we will see. Yes.
So. Download jars.
Right.
What's the difference between that and an Eclipse plugin for Selenium? What's the difference between a plugin and a jar?
It's different. Plugin is different. Plugin is in the sense that inbuilt software. Plugin itself also it's inbuilt software. But the jar is not like that. The jar is a software. Jar contains many classes and methods and so on, but is different. Plugin is automatically can installable, but jars cannot be installable. We can only do the configuration.
Okay.
So configuration is different, installation is different. Plugins and other softwares can be only installed. The WebDriver is not an installer. WebDriver is not a plugin. Okay, it is a package or it is API which can be configurable, not for installable. Okay. Right. So WebDriver is not a plugin. Okay. So TestNG and other software comes as a plugins, but WebDriver is not a plugin. Right. So this is how we need to configure WebDriver project. Now let us start writing a simple WebDriver. Okay. As I said WebDriver by default support Firefox driver. And also Internet Explorer and Chrome supports multiple driver, multiple browser. Before that, one more thing we need to do. So we need to download some drivers for browsers. So for every browser, even though we use classes, Firefox driver class, Internet Explorer driver class, Chrome driver class, even though we have used classes, we need to also download drivers for appropriate browsers. So for every browser, there will be a driver. Okay, some Firefox driver, there will be a Jacoco driver. And Internet Explorer, there is a one driver, Microsoft driver. And Chrome driver, for Chrome browser, there will be a Chrome driver. So there are many drivers are there. You can also download online, or else I can also provide, I'll put in the Google Drive. I'll show you. See this one, chromedriver.exe. This is a Chrome driver. So we are going to use this driver in our program. Okay. If you want to interact with a Chrome browser, we need this particular driver. Another way, if you want to interact with the Explorer, then we need e-drivers.exe, this Internet Explorer. Similar to the Firefox browser, we need to have a joker.exe. This is another file. For Firefox driver. So for every browser, there is a driver. So just similar like JDBC. In JDBC, if you want to interact with the database, Oracle database, we use Oracle driver. Similarly, if you want to interact with SQL Server, we used SQL Server driver. Similar way, if you want to interact with the Internet Explorer or Chrome or some other browser, we need to use appropriate browsers, appropriate question. Drivers. Okay? Yes.
Question. So if one Googles for documentation on those drivers, you'll yes. will be able to find documentation.
Yes, yes. In Selenium, here itself, you can say download, right? In the download section, from here also, so the Internet Explorer driver. So 32-bit and 64-bit, both are available. So you can download here. And little come down here. So here, Mozilla Gecko driver. So this is a Firefox driver. So Google Chrome driver. So this is a Chrome driver, Opera driver. So for every browser, there will be on the same download session page. Okay, and you don't need to go and search for Google. Okay, so
and everything is available. Where's the documentation there?
The documentation, we talk about Selenium, all the components, classes, packages are there, right? It will give us the information. So when you click on the documentation, all the information about the different components and how to use it and what are the things and features are available and how to use these features and everything will be provided here. Okay, this is official documentation. And we need to always refer the download session. Everything will be available under download session. Okay. Right. So now let us start writing a simple program. So as I said before that, I need to download a drivers. So different drivers are required if you want to interact with the three different browsers. First, let us see Firefox. Then we go for other browsers. Okay. Now let me create a new program. So let me new package first. So here, I'm creating the package. Okay. So Selenium dot WebDriver dot basic tests. This is my package. Okay. So usual names seems like this. Selenium dot WebDriver dot basic tests. Under this, I will create all my basic tests. Now create a class. Just like a normal Java program, okay? So this is my first test. Now take main method, finish. Okay, this is a normal class. Now we need to start working on this. So before that, let me show you a simple application. I'll show you a small test case. Yes, so now here, this is my test case. So step one, open a browser, open URL here, and enter some username, enter password, click on OK button, and last check the page title. This is my validation. So this is a simple test case, very basic test case. So I want to automate this. So let me open this particular application. Okay, so this is a online reservation, flight reservation system. This is a basic kind of sample application or demo kind of application. So this is my application. So if I enter Mercury is a username and Mercury is a password, click on the sign in button. It will log in into the home page. Okay, so this is the basic thing. I want to automate this flow. So I want to open the browser first. Then I want to open the URL. I want to enter the username here. I enter the password and I need to click on the sign in button. After that, I want to verify the title of the page. Okay, verify the title of the page. Now, so this is a scenario. Okay, this is my test case. Now let us start automating. Come back to the program here. The first and most important thing is we are going to use which browser we are going to use, that we need to decide. Okay, so first let us start with the Firefox browser, then I will introduce IE and Chrome also. Okay, so the first important thing is we are going to use Firefox browser, so we need to use Firefox driver. So but our program doesn't know where my Firefox driver is available. So what I should do now is first statement I should say to my program where my Firefox driver is available. So for that I need to use one statement, system dot set property. This is a method. So how these methods will come, these methods are already present in the jar file, so we are going to use them. Yes, so system dot set property, here we need to provide a key, web driver dot Firefox dot MARIONETTE. So this is a basically class name they have used in Firefox driver. Okay, so in within the Firefox driver, this is a key. Okay, and then dot, sorry, not dot. So this is the key. So where it, this key is present under a driver. So where the driver is present, that location I need to specify. So when you go here, in Eclipse location, my Firefox driver is present under program files, Eclipse. Somewhere my JCoco driver is present. So Eclipse, I can take the latest version. So this is exe file, remove the S part. Okay, this is my latest version of JCoco driver. Copy entire path here.
So how did you know that Gecko was the one you wanted? If you're doing
because Firefox.
Firefox is using this particular
Firefox
driver to remember. Okay, you need to remember this. So for every browser, there will be a separate driver. So if you want to use Internet Explorer, this is another driver, IE driver server exe. If you want to use another driver, Chrome driver.exe, but names are similar to the browser, but especially for Firefox, the name is a little different.
So what if I forget that it's Gecko driver? How could I find out which one it is?
This is basically JCoco driver. This is a name itself says, this is a basically for only Firefox driver. So if you go to the documentation section, here downloads, you come down a little bit. It's saying like Mozilla JCoco driver,
yeah,
right? So
when you Mozilla download JCoco, itself, it's saying that.
Yes. See, that's what JCoco driver is only for Mozilla Firefox. That's okay. What the browser name is given. Okay.
Sure. Okay. Good. Right. Thanks.
So this is how
one question Pavan, because
yes,
you mentioned the key actually webdriver.firefox.marinate.
Yes.
So yes. For that marinate is like for the Firefox only, or it's
yes,
like
yes,
for any,
it's only for Firefox. This key is only for Firefox driver. Wherever you use Firefox driver, you need to specify this
then
key.
We'll,
and also
okay,
you need to provide the path of that particular driver. So when you provide the path
okay
of the driver, yeah, you need to use forward slashes. Remember this point, okay? Because here Java will not understand the backward slashes, okay? Forward slashes, and also you need to provide the name of the driver, exe, right? Copy entire thing, the name, and specify that one here. Okay, this is how. And then
okay,
close the bracket. So this is how we need to do system.setProperty. Remember this method. System dot, this is the first statement you need to write. System.setProperty, key value, and then path of the driver. Path of the driver. So same thing will applicable for Internet Explorer and Chrome also, but key will be changed and path also same, but the driver name will be changed. Okay, I'll show you that, just hold on. So the first thing is we need to do the system.set property. This is the first statement which we need to do. And the second thing is we are going to use WebDriver, right? We are going to use, as I said, WebDriver is an interface which is implemented by using multiple classes. So which class we are going to use now? Which class we have to use now?
So we are Firefox. Going to
use the first, Firefox driver class.
Yes, so we are going to use Firefox browser, so that we have to use this particular class, Firefox driver class. So for that class, I cannot directly use class, right? I can create an object for that particular class. So what I can do is Firefox driver, okay, suppose driver is an object name equal to new Firefox driver. This is how we need to use.
Now, the first Firefox.
Yes.
Right.
Right. Just a moment. Okay. Now, when you observe this, as soon as I use this particular class name, it is showing an error. So, because if I see, put the cursor there, it will giving a suggestion. What is the suggestion? Import Firefox driver. Where it is available? This is a class again, right? This so class is present under org.openqa.selenium.firefox. So, in this particular package, the class is present. So when I click on this, it will import the new class, import a new package. So till this, it is a package and this is the class name, because this class name is present under this particular package. Okay, now I have created an object which is referring to this particular Firefox browser. So as soon as I created this, what will happen? So Firefox driver is also a constructor, is available under this particular class. So as soon as I created an object, automatically the constructor will invoke the browser. It will invoke the browser. You got my point? So Firefox driver is a class. I have created an object and also have done instantiation. So Firefox driver is a class, and also within this particular class, there is a constructor called Firefox driver constructor. What is constructor? What is constructor?
An initializer.
Constructor is a kind of a method with having the same name of class, and it will invoke it automatically at the time of instantiation. Remember?
Yes.
Right? Constructor having the same name of the class name, and also it will invoke automatically at the time of instantiation. That's what we discussed in the last classes, right? So similar way, Firefox driver is a class. Within the class, there is a constructor called Firefox driver constructor. Okay. So when, as soon as an instantiation like this, what happens internally, the constructor will invoke the browser. Invoke the browser. That code is already implemented in the Firefox driver constructor. So when I execute this script just now, as of now, I have created only two statements. One is I have set the system property as a Firefox browser driver, and then I have created this object of Firefox driver class. Now when I execute this, what happens? It will invoke the browser. Right click, run as Java application. Now when you observe this, it will invoke the Firefox browser actually. Now you observe here, this is empty browser. It doesn't contain any, this is purely empty browser. Okay, so browser is invoked. So this is how it will do. So it will show some suggestions like this. So just ignore this one. Now what happens? This statement will invoke the browser. Invoke the browser. Invoke the browser. Now what is the next step? What is our test case? Come back to the test case. Let me copy this in your program. This is my test case. This is my comment. Okay, so this is my test case. Now we open the browser. Through this state, I opened my browser. And we can also define the same statement in different way. Observe this one. I can also do like this. Instead of Firefox driver class, I can also specify WebDriver interface name. People also will use like this. See me now, what is the difference between one and this one?
When you use the web driver over there, you have to specify the object also new web driver, right?
So either we can go this way or we can go this way. So if I define like the second way, what is the difference between this one and this one?
Well, the return, the expected return is a web driver as opposed to.
My question is actually when you create an object, actually you have to give the same kind of thing, right? When you Firefox driver new Firefox driver, that's what you give. You have to create new.
That's what I'm asking. Actually, this concept I explained in the interfaces concept. So here, this is the class name. This is the interface name. This is WebDriver is an interface. Here I have used class name. One point I discussed while explaining interface. Interface, we can create an object, but we cannot instantiate. Right? Do you remember that point? Interface. Can create an object reference for interface, but we cannot instantiate interface, right? So that is the reason I cannot use WebDriver here. This is wrong. Okay. So, but instead of this, what I can do, whatever is class is implemented, this WebDriver interface, that class name I can specify here. So what is the class name implemented WebDriver? So this is my class.
Right.
This is valid statement.
Because
I say WebDriver, again this WebDriver is interface is present under org.openqa.selenium package. Import that package. Okay, now a new package is import.
Same.
Okay, WebDriver is interface. Okay. Now this one and this one both are same, no difference. Some people will use like this and some people will use like this. Okay. So WebDriver driver equal to new Firefox driver. And this is more generic actually. So because if I say the first method, okay, this driver object only pointing to the Firefox driver, Firefox browser. But if you want to use multiple browsers, so then I can't restrict with this, right? Suppose if I say here, so instead of Firefox driver, I can use Internet Explorer driver, also I can use Chrome driver. So or else any other browser I can use it, right? This is a generic statement. So most of the time, instead of going this one, we will prefer this one. Both will do the same job. Okay. Now, let me execute this statement also. Either you can go for this one or this one. This will also invoke the browser. Invoke the browser. So let me, I commented this statement and then I have created this one. Now, let me execute once again. So now this will also invoke the browser, empty browser. Okay, we haven't provided any URL as of now, right? Just it will open the browser, Firefox browser. Now, so we have done only one step still now. So open the browser is done or invoke the browser. Open the browser or invoke the browser. So what's the next step? Open URL open that particular URL. Browser. Okay, so if you want to open the URL, we have to use certain methods for this driver object. So why we have created this object? Because we cannot directly use an interface or we cannot directly use this particular class. But this class contains certain methods. If you want to use those methods, I must create an object. That is called driver object I have created. Now, if I use driver dot, it will show lot many methods. These are all the different methods which are available under Firefox driver class. Okay, so through object I can access everything. Now if you want to open a URL in a browser, I have a method called driver.get. So this method will open a URL in the browser. So whatever URL I'm going to open, just copy that URL, just pass the URL as parameter here. Now what this statement will do, this statement will open this URL on this particular browser. So this is the second term. Open URL in the browser. Okay, now let me execute once again. The first statement will invoke browser and on the same browser this statement driver.get will open the URL. Now execute, run as Java application. Now you observe here, first empty browser and then it opens the URL. Now application is open. Okay, so next, what is the next step? So we open the application, login. We open the browser, login. We open the application, then we need to enter username and the password. We need to click on OK button. So this is very important concept again. If you want to enter username and the password, application, let me open one application. Okay, so this is my application, right? So if you observe this one, the application is a different software. This is a different window and my browser is different window. So the my clips is different, right? Both are different. Now when I executing them and I execute, I want to interact with these elements, username box and the password box. If I want to enter something here, I want to identify these two elements, right? This is called web text boxes or web elements. We can call as web elements. So in web page, whatever is appear here, everything is a web element. Link is web element, image is web element. Okay, so text box is web element, button is also one more web element. So these are all comes under the web elements. So if you want to enter something here, I need to interact with the text box. I want to interact with this. So how we can interact? How we can interact? For interacting that particular element, we require two things. Very important. So for today, I am just explaining the high level, but in the next class onwards, I'll go deeper into this. I have a username text box. Okay, suppose I have a text box. So I want to identify this text box. I want to talk to this text box. So I require two things. One is property of that element. Property is nothing but I need to get some address, property or address of that element. And based upon the address, I want to catch that object, right? Catching that object. For that, I use some method. For catching that object, I will use some method. And if you want to catch that object, I need some address or I need some property, right? Okay, so these two things are required. So now I have a username box and the password box here. I have username box and password box. Two things are there. So first thing is I want to interact with the username. How we can interact? So before interacting with the username, I want to get certain properties. Okay, so now let us see what are all properties are available for username box. How we will know? There is a Firebug plugin. Firebug plugin. So by using this Firebug plugin, we can know what are all properties are available for this particular text box. So just open this plugin. It will open up a window at the bottom. Now there is an inspect button, arrow mark. Just click on this and then highlight that particular button. Now when you highlight this particular button here, so it will show some properties. Input type equal to text, size equal to 10, name equal to username, right? So basically we prefer IDs and names if it is available, or else we can go for some other properties. These are basically called as locators. So what is locator? Locator will identify that particular element. Okay, unique property which will identify that element. So I'll talk about more about locators in the next coming classes in deeper. But as of now, for this particular class, just understand, just we need to capture one locator. This is a name locator, right? This is for username. Copy here. And then similarly, we also should capture property for the password box. So then password box. So here if you see, name of the password is this one. Copy this one. And also we need to click on sign in button, right? So again go to the sign in button. Highlight the sign in button. And for sign in button, it is showing multiple properties, and I can take the name property. Name equal to login. Take this value. So now we got all the properties and addresses of the elements. Right, so now we can use them in your program. Now observe, very important. Now coming back to your program. Now we have opened the URL in application. Now the next thing is we need to interact with the username. So if you want to interact with the username, so let me write the statement like this. Observe very carefully. Driver dot find element of by dot name of username. Explain this statement, just to hold on. Dot send case of Mercury. Observe this statement. If you observe this one, it is very easier to go further. Okay, so just observe this one. Where is that element present in the page? So currently driver is an object which will point into the browser page, right? So now all the methods are available in the driver object. So find element is a method. Driver dot find element is a method which will find that element. Observe this one. First method is find element. Is used for finding the element on the page. This is the first thing. Remember that. Find element is a method which is finding the element on the page. If this find element method want to find that element, it required certain address of that element, right? Address of that element or property of an element. Based on that, it can identify that element or it can find that element. So we have another property inside by dot name. So there are many things actually, by dot name, by dot id, by dot xpath. There are so many locators are there, but currently I'm using only name because for all three properties, all three elements I have taken as a name. So I use only by dot name. So what by dot name will take here, we need to provide the exact property. So what by dot name is, it will provide address of the element. Address of the element. So the first method will find that element, and the second method by dot name, by dot id, by dot xpath. There are many number of methods are there. So these methods are present under by class. By is a predefined class, and these methods are static methods so that we can directly access those methods by using class name itself. Okay, so by dot name will provide the address of that element, and find element will find that element based upon the address which is written by the by dot name. This is the relation between this one and this one. Now you observe this first statement coming from here. So internal statement by dot name of username will provide the address of that element, and find element will find that element based on the address which is written by dot name. You got my point? Is it clear or any confusion here?
Yeah.
Okay. No. So internal by dot name will provide us the address of that element, and then find element will immediately catch that element based on the address. After catching that element, we need to enter some text. So if you want to provide some text, we have to use send keys method. So another method is send keys method. Used for entering some text in the text box. So these are the only three methods we have used. So here just high level I am introduced these three methods, and going further we will I'll explain more about these methods. Okay, find element, by dot name, and send keys method. Find element method is used for finding that element based on the address, and who will provide address? By dot name will provide address. So by dot name is provided address. Based on the address, find element is identified that element, and once we identify that element, we need to enter some value into that particular element. So that for that reason we have to use send keys method. Now entire thing is like this: driver dot find element of by dot name. So till then it will identify that element. Now send the method which will enter some text in the text box. So this is a whole state. Is it clear?
Yeah.
Okay. Now the same statement we can also write in two different ways. Two different statements. I can split this entire statement in two different ways. Then write one statement. What the statement It will find that element.
Yeah.
It will not perform any operation. It will just find that element. So it find and return that element, right? We yep. want to store that element in some variable. So now, what can be type of this variable now? It will return a web element. It will return the web element. That web element can be stored in some variable. Now tell me what kind of variable it should be?
It's a string.
Web element type, not a web element type, because this will return in web element, and also this should be web element type.
Okay.
You got my point?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we need to import the web element. Now, statement is returning web element. If you want to store them in variable, the variable must be web element. Now, using this variable, I can directly use send case method. Okay, so instead of writing one statement, I can write two statements like this. Either you can go for this or you can go for this. So here, the first statement, I haven't used any separate variable here. So I can directly use here dot send case. Is it clear now? Fine?
Yes.
Now we have entered the value in the using box. So similar way, I will also enter value the password box. Now tell me driver dot
find element
by dot name
password.
So what is the name of the password? This is the password. Name of the copy go here and put the quotations
and then
now send. Till then it will send identify key. The element. Now send keys of
send key.
Mercury. Okay, now we also enter the password. Now last thing, we need to click on the button. So driver dot
find
element by dot name of, what is the name of the login button?
Login.
So login.
Some of the places it is signed, so we can use the sign in also.
No, even though the page is signing, see observe here, that is sign in.
Yeah.
But when you see the property here, login is there. Name is login.
Okay.
So now here login dot. So now tell me which method I have to use. If you want to enter some text, we used send keys method. But if you want to click on the button,
click.
We need to use click method. Click method. Okay. Now after clicking, so let me execute till then. So I have opened the browser, invoke the browser, open the URL. So here enter username and here enter password and here click on sign in, right? So now let me execute the script. MS Java. Observe, it opened the URL and it entered username and password, and also it clicked on the sign in button. It is logged into the home page. This is fine, perfectly correct. Now, have we included any validation point in this test? No validation point. So we have made the right. So it. So the final check the page title. Title of the page. Title of the page. So if you want to verify the title of the page, at least we should know what is expected title, right? Then I can capture I can capture the actual title and expected title, and I can compare actual title with expected title. If both are equal, my test is passed. If both are not equal, my test is fail. So before that, let me take string expected title equal to, let me take the what is expected title. So how we will know title of this particular home page? Just right here, view page source. So the title here, it will show. Okay, this is the title of the page. Okay, so this is my expected title. Right, now actual title we will get. So at the runtime after login is successful, I need to capture the title of the page. So how we need to get the title of the page? So there is another method, driver object dot get title. This is a method, get title. So this method will return the title of the page, actual title of the page, okay? Returns the title of the page. Okay, now if it returns title of the page, we can store that value into the string variable. String, this is actual title, right? Actual title equal to driver.getTitle. Now we have expected title, also we have actual title. We need to compare these two. So how to compare? If condition, if expect, how to compare two strings? Compare.
Yeah, equal to.
Yes, equals or equals ignore case, right? So take this one, first string dot equals equals and the second string. Okay, so expected title dot equals actual title. If this is true, then I say system dot router dot println test is passed. So else, if it is not equal, my test is fail. Else
fail.
System dot out dot println test is failed. Okay, now this is a verification point or validation. Okay, now have we completed a complete test case, right? So we open the browser, open the URL, enter username, password, click on the OK button and then verify the page. Now let us check actual and expected title are equal or not. So now execute again. Run as Java application. Now you have observed. Entering username, password, sign in. Page still open. Okay, now come back to the program. Program is executed. What is saying? Test is failed. Test is failed. Why it is failed? Because somewhere I have this. Execute. Okay, now test is passed. See, after test is passed, program is executed, but still it is open. Now I want is the close page option. After actually done, I want to close the page automatically. I don't want to close this page manually like this. So how we can do is, we can say driver dot, it is a method class, close, driver dot close. So this method will close the browser. Close the browser. So how many methods will learn? Find element, by dot name, send keys, click method, get title, then close methods. Totally six methods we learn today. Okay, now execute once again. Now you automatically close once the validation is done. Closed. So closed and test is also passed. Okay. So this is how we need to implement the script. So we have seen only the file, right? How to open the Firefox browser, how to open the
URL. Because when you open the Firefox browser, usually that the Firefox browser comes with the Firebug. Or do we need to download the Firebug?
No. Firebug is a manual utility actually. So you need to install the plugin. So when I open this Firebug.
Yeah, because I have a Firefox, but I never see the Firebug over there. So we have to okay.
Let me show you Firebug. So this is a purely Firefox browser. So go here, add-ons.
Okay.
So just search here Firebug. Okay, now if you see this one, FirePath is also important. I'll talk about this in next classes. So Firebug, if you have enabled here, that means you haven't added that plugin to your Firefox. Make sure it should be enabled here. Okay, so if you disable this, it will not appear. If you enable this, it will appear.
Here, right? So these two are pretty much same, or Firebug and Firefox.
We're getting the XPath. I'll explain Firefox in coming classes. Okay.
Okay.
Firebug is only for showing all the properties of the elements.
Okay.
Firepath is used for getting the XPath. So XPath is also one kind of locator, just like ID, name, CSS locator, XPath. So there are so many locators are available. Okay. So I will explain all of them in the coming classes. So there I will also explain what is a Firepath, how to use this. Okay. So just now you install a Firebug and check. This is simple for the Firebug. Okay. So this is how we need to do the basic script. So in the next class, I'll show you how to do the same script, how to execute the same script on the Internet Explorer and also Chrome browsers.
Okay.
I'll stop for today here. So any questions on this?
No. I would like to download the Selenium and whatever the basic test you provided today, I would like to see, because to get the use of calling the driver calling and all. So let me try that one. So I will try that.
Try the same program today. So I'll provide assignments after 2 or 3 days. Okay, at least you should have a concepts, and then you are able to do the assignments. Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Right. So just try the same program again today. Just open the URL and open the browser. Open the URL and try to enter some usernames and passwords. You can take any other site. Okay. I'll also provide some other sites. If you want, you can try them. Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Fine. So let us see tomorrow class and with the other browsers.
Sure. Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you.